estamos en vivo.
This is the city of the sun.
El Paso Nexa.
Paso, happy Friday to you guys. Thank you so much for being with us on episode 36 of Life and Talented. You guys, that's more than half a year that you've been with us every Friday night, so we thank you for that. For tonight's show, we have a surprise for you. We're gonna be rerunning the first ever local icon to come to Life and Talented, Mr. Dub T. He now lives in Atlanta and he's working on some great projects. He has a song with 2 Chainz coming out. So I'm excited because I actually got to interview him. And for our Glam It Up segment, we have CDH. All right, let's go ahead and kick it off with our local icon.
This segment is brought to you by...
Get discovered, get exposure, and play at the next level. Prep One. Follow us on all social media platforms.
Welcome back, El Paso. This is Live and Talented, and it's going to be a special one. And we have a very, very special guest with us. But I want to introduce first Miss Larissa. Come on out, please.
Hi.
Wow, look at her. You're like a Barbie. You're like a Barbie. All right.
Guys, I am so excited, not just for the segment that we have with local icons, but because our next guest is an amazing artist, and not only is he amazing, but during the time that we chit-chatted before this, he is so humble, so amazing.
I agree.
So I'm so excited to introduce him to you guys. We have Dub T, so it is an honor to welcome Dub T.
Dub T, everybody.
What it do, what it do.
Hey, hey.
What's up, this Larissa?
Man, you always looking fly, man.
Beautiful introduction. Excellent.
Good?
Everybody good?
Have a seat.
Good. Appreciate y'all having me live in effect on the show.
All right. Well, Dub, how about we do a little quick cheers? Yeah. Salud. Salud. Your mic's on.
Salud.
There we go. If you guys are wondering what we're drinking, it's just milk.
Yeah.
It's
yes.
Just milk.
Oh, 2% milk. Well, low fat, you know.
Hey. I want to start off with, I want people to know who Dub T is after this. I mean, look, I want to go on, and I'll let everybody know. You and I met at the gym one day.
EP Fitness.
EP. We're throwing them on there already.
Shout out.
You and I met at the gym, and man, you hit it hard. But one of the first conversations is how your career was in a pause. I want you to kind of give us a little bit of background with this, man, because I know this is really going to, it's really marked a big, you know, part of your life.
It is. And for you to see that, recognize that, man, I appreciate it. It was one of the hardest times in my life. I broke, let me put the list, broke, fractured, dislocated, shattered, and tore my tendon in my ankle. That was all in my ankle, left ankle. I tore my ACL and my MCL in my right knee. So that's my left ankle to my right knee. And then I severed my tendon in my elbow, in my left elbow, all in one hit. So,
my goodness.
Semi-pro football, you know what I'm saying? Because I love sports. I played college baseball. You know, I was a very
good.
So
it happened in sports?
It happened in sports.
In football.
Like live action. No, like. Backyard with the guys on flag football. No.
Dub T wasn't a rapper. He would be a professional.
I it, it I don't think I had the height for the football. I definitely had the skill, but the height on football, I chose baseball in college.
Okay.
I got both offers, you know, to go football, but D2 in football, and then I got an offer D1 in baseball.
Oh, wow.
And baseball players have longevity. Longer than a football player. I love football more than baseball, though. Getting paid to go to school, and what if I get hurt my freshman year? They're not going to want to pay me the three next years. So I chose baseball. And I wanted to be just the first baseman just so I can, like I said, keep my longevity. But they chose me as the goddamn catcher. So I got beat up every day. But blah, blah, blah. So that's just here, you know, something that put me in the mindset that I am now.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
You're a whole different man after that accident, huh? You're a whole different person.
So I get hurt and I'm in the hospital. I didn't even call the ambulance. They literally had to pick me up, put me in the truck, and take me to the hospital. I'm so stubborn on hospitals. I grew up in hospitals. My dad's actually a kidney transplant patient. He's been on dialysis since 96. You know, had two transplants here and there. So that's here and there. But so I lived in hospitals my whole entire life. So I hate them. I hate them. So I'm in the hospital. I can't walk. I can't really do anything. And they're like, well, you can't even put pressure on your legs. Because they tried to put me up on the crutches and just for one leg on my knee because they didn't know if it was torn or not because I couldn't get an MRI in the emergency room. So they just did the broke, and all this stuff, you know. So I tried to put pressure on my right knee, and I could not. So they're like, you're going to have to stay here. No, I paid for a $5,000 ambulance trip from Vista del Sol, the Del Sol, right there off of Yarbrough, to George Dieter, $5,000. Just because I did not want to stay in the hospital.
Expensive Uber, huh?
Oh, my God. But I just...
Uber.
I hate hospitals, like I said. So I get home, and I literally... They gurney me from the ambulance to the couch, right to the couch, boom. And I'm still in my football, lower football stuff.
Wow.
So I sleep like that, wake up, and the next morning I figure out that I cannot walk.
So they didn't do anything from the sole?
I mean, they put my left ankle back in place as much as possible. They wanted to do an emergency surgery on it, but the doctor was in surgery and was a little tired, and he said, I do not want to have to come back out and go back in there, because then it's going to be worse for me. You're going into scar tissue second time is worse.
Yeah.
So he's like, let's schedule in a week. They put it back. They put me out real quick for like 5 minutes, try to put it back as much as possible. And in a week later, I got that surgery. But I realized from one day to the next, I cannot walk.
Jesus Christ, man. I mean, and you know, people that have car accidents, things like that, that mark your life.
And that don't, that can't walk after it. I praise you guys. I'm like, God, like that to be so mobile how we do. We go to the gym. We're always running around. I'm always running around doing things to be able to just sit on the couch. I'm not that type of person like to just sit there. I don't like that.
How long were you out?
2.5 years. I couldn't because you couldn't put pressure on the left ankle because it was shattered. Everything was gone. You can't put pressure on the right knee because I have two tears. So I'm literally in a wheelchair for 2 years.
Oh, you're crazy.
So I did the surgery the next week. On the left ankle, that took 8.5 months to heal and to be able to put a little pressure. So 9 months, I got this one. Right when I could put a little pressure on this one, I got this one. Right when I could get a little pressure on this one, I did this one. Three major surgeries. I had to get my elbow replaced, pretty much the tendon and the tip of the elbow replaced in all those. So three major surgeries in 2 years.
I actually
broken
was
bones?
In a car accident and I my tendons from my ankle down and on one foot.
Ugh.
And I was in a wheelchair for about 2 months. And I remember I was running varsity track back in high school.
Yeah.
What high school?
Coronado.
Ooh, West Side.
Where are you?
What high school are you from?
I went to Cathedral.
Cathedral?
I went to Cathedral. They picked me up for baseball. Graduated in 07. So, yeah. So I went to Cathedral. My brother was recruited there for football.
Okay.
And they said, look, we will go ahead and pay for your first year in 2 years if you come here.
Okay.
So he went there. And I actually met the baseball coach when I was going to seventh grade that summer. You know, community college league, baseball league. So my brother was going to be a sophomore or a junior or something like that. And he was on the community college league for Cathedral. And he asked me, he's like, hey, come play with us. So I'm like, all right, because he knew I had the talent. So I'm barely about to be in seventh grade. It's summer, right? So he asked me to go out there. the head coach for Cathedral's out there, and I go 3-for-3 with like 2 stolen bases. And he's like, he's going to be a freshman next year? And my mom's like, no, he's going to be in 7th grade. So, no, and I'm hit.
So you got paid. Your school was paid ever since?
No, my brother was the one who got the offer to get recruited for Cathedral.
Okay.
I got recruited because he saw his head coach saw me playing a summer league, and he's like, he's going to Cathedral. So they groomed me to go there. So I was going automatic. You know what I mean?
So you never experienced public high school?
Public high school, no.
Oh.
No. Okay. Public school all the way through until high school.
So let me just start off. Dup T. I know you're called Dup T.
Yes, ma'am.
But what is your name? Do you like people calling you Dup T or?
Dub.
Dub. Dub. Or Dub. What do you go by?
Dub. Dub T.
Dub T.
Or Will Taylor. Will. That. Yeah, I mean, you did your research. Wait. I was just about to ask. You did your research.
Come on.
I know this is an interview for me. You're going to ask me a question, but can I possibly ask you, do you think you know how it came out?
I don't know.
Will Taylor. My name, it's just my initials, like T.I.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Got it. Okay.
Tip Harris, T.I.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? That's T.I.'s name. So
T.I. was one of my favorite artists.
Fire.
Oh, my God.
That's my dog.
Well, Dub, it's time to talk a little bit more about your professional artist life.
Let's get it.
And I know there's a lot of stuff that I've already seen that I know Larissa's going to touch on as well. But you're a very interesting person, man. I mean, just aside from everything that I already seen you do, you're very interesting. And I think it's fun for people to see this.
So we have this amazing athlete, baseball, football, your brother. How did you transition from sports to becoming this amazing rapper?
My junior year of college, we're in mid-season of baseball. Like I said, I was playing college baseball, not football. I was sitting in my car after practice, and we have 2-a-days, and you have school all day. So I'm tired as shit, frustrated as hell, you know, because it's school. You know, I'm just trying to make sure we get these, keep these grades up, blah, blah, blah. I'm listening to Biggie, Sky's the Limit. You know, Sky's is the limit. I love that song, okay? I had heard it 1,000 times before that. So it just was on. It just came up on the playlist. Smoking a blunt, mind you. Sorry, coaches, but I still performed. You didn't know. There you go.
You were like a million other artists.
They don't even. They didn't even know. Athletes. They couldn't even. No. Second in all our running, all that kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? Blah blah blah. So I'm listening to the song, and I'm so frustrated at the time. I had just, pretty much found out I was going to have a kid. And going so that Here summer before college. That summer before that when I was a sophomore that summer sophomore summer
you have a kid already yeah one or two
I have two
you have two boys
11-year-old boy Latrell.
Oh wow.
Yes. And an 8-year-old daughter Nevaeh.
Nice.
Okay.
All right,
so
we'll touch on that right now.
I'm going from transitioning to coming back from summer in El Paso, you know, going back to school, and I was so frustrated. I can't explain the how and why. It's just everything going on, you know. He said, only make moves when your heart's in it. And I was like,
now's the time.
I was like, rewind. Only make moves when your heart's in it. And nothing had clicked in my entire life like that had. I'm talking, it spoke to me. And like I said, I had heard the song 1,000 times before. But at that exact moment of time in my life, it was the perfect time to hear it. Only make moves when your heart's in it. Yes, I do encourage every and all kids and anyone to get your education first. But if you are not doing it wholeheartedly, why are you doing it at all? So I heard that, and I could not believe how much passion and fire I had to rap, because I just started freestyling that summer. Like in parties, like, you know, we're getting high, doing all this, blah, blah, blah. We having a good time because I got to go back to school. I got to go back to school and not do none of this. So I'm going to have a good time. So I'm freestyling. The first time I ever freestyled, we're all lit. People are freestyling. And I just felt the beat. And I, you know what I'm saying? And what they're talking about, I was like, I know you ain't about that. You know what I mean? So I'm like, I know I'm about it. I done it. I do it.
Yeah.
So I jumped in and I started freestyling for about a minute and a half. This couple, I stopped. Everybody's like, oh, shit. This couple right next to me, actually, the guy pulls off his glasses and, say no to drugs. He was actually he's rolling, and if you don't know what that is, you know, he's on some ecstasy, him and his girl. So he takes his glasses off, and he's dancing. He's like, "Why'd you stop?" And I was like, "What?" He's like, "Why'd you stop?" I was like, "He's what do you mean?" He's like, "You were making my roll go up." Really? So if you know about raves and stuff like that, you know, I'm not, like I said, say no to drugs. But when you go to a rave, people is high and they're vibing with the music, and the music takes them higher with what they're on. So what I spit made him go higher. And you know, he was when he took his glasses off, I'm talking. you could tell he was on something. And at that moment, I said, if I can do that to somebody live, imagine if I start rapping and recording. And nothing I said was a lie. That's why
so
I jumped
this
in.
This is in college, man. So you had an experience in high school.
I didn't know I could rap. That's not crazy. That I didn't love rap. I love rap. But I just never tried to freestyle. You know, on high school buses, you know, on the school football buses, they be rapping. Everybody be freestyling. I be in the back hyping. Never rapped. Never knew I could. Never knew I could. Until that moment, I was lit too. So it was just the right song, right vibe. It was like 20 people in the circle. It was like 100 people in the house. You know, everybody's partying. Yeah. It was just the right time.
So after that, like, what happened? Like, did you pursue it? Did you quit college? Or what happened?
Did I pursue it? Oh man. Okay. No. I feel you.
100%.
No.
Did you go all in, or
did you finish college? Were you there?
That's why I'm saying. Did I go with it? Oh my God. 2 weeks later,
gone.
I told my roommate, because we're in the sports complex of the dorm, so only athletes are in this complex. So I tell my roommate, which is he's an outfielder. I say, hey, my jerseys are in the closet. I'm leaving. What the fuck you doing? What do you mean? I'm like, I'm gonna rap. I'm gonna go rap. He's like, what? Okay. He's like, hey, can I keep the fridge or can I send it to you? Because I don't got one. I was like, take it, bro. Fuck it. Left. Mind you that my parents, oh my God, I had nowhere to go. just know that. No, I could not go back there.
And this is right at the same time that you're about to have a kid.
Yes.
Dude, that's crazy, yes, man.
So, yeah.
You had some balls to go do that move.
I
listened to that song wholeheartedly.
it's tatted on me, sir. it is on me, brother. So
that's good, man.
I lived the move. I felt it in my heart. I felt it in my gut. I knew it, and that was the time. I was like, if I stay longer, it may linger. And I'd be like, well, I'll just rap on the side or something like that. No, fuck that.
Yeah.
Thank you both.
Let's. I'm gonna get tell my director Christian to get ready with. The first video that we're going to watch.
Well, you know what?
Seconds.
Hold on. I'm sorry to interrupt
okay.
you.
Oh, yeah.
I got some Dub T gear real quick. You know, let me.
Sup,
oh, he's
Julian.
Bringing it to me, dog. Oh, my dog. Yeah, he brought it to me, dog.
He needs to be in here.
Yeah. I got you some gear.
I see Caesar. Can you get a close up, Caesar?
Real quick.
Look at that.
Larissa, hey, what color hat and shirt do you like? So I can go ahead and get that ready for you and I go ahead and get that sent.
Like
this one?
Yeah.
That one's dope.
Yeah.
What color do you have? I mean,
I got red, blue. I'll send you the
hey,
list.
Hey, Caesar,
I got royal
get a
blue,
close-up
red,
of
black.
This of his hat, please. There
Dubt905.com. Dubt905.com.
There
you
we
check
go.
Check out my apparel. Yes.
Hey, Dub.
Course.
Well, let's continue on real quick. We want to show people a little bit of some of your videos. What's this first one we're going to look at? Is it a?
Like I said, the song is called Camera Shake featuring Hilda. We actually shot that here at Jags. You know, shout out
we
to
Jags. We were wondering. We were like, is it Jags?
Yes.
Let me find out you underage people have been.
That's what I'm saying. So shout out to Jags for that. It's a dope video. Go check it out.
Let's check it out. Let's check out the first 30, yeah? Let's roll it.
Where you at, Daddy? All right, well, I miss you. Be safe.
We drop a strip club money, caught that strip club fan. Got it hundreds on my watch, 10 chickens on my chain, like salad dressing on my chain, like. She get that late night money, bust tricks, two flips, scrap money, cocaine. Keep the appetite fit, life. Money, I begin, like. Money, I begin, like. Sick shot of got a lot of money.
Dude, this is some top of the line. Yeah. I was like, whoa!
Shout out to the dancers, they killed that shit.
I don't know what else you got for us, Larissa.
Nothing. I just want to ask, what future plans do you have? What is Dub T working on? What should we expect from you?
We got a track with 2 Chainz coming out. They are still mixing and mastering it, touching it up in the studio. What? It has been recorded.
Hey.
2 Chainz, shout out 2 Chainz. Hey, appreciate you giving me a chance, my dog. You know what I'm saying? So he recorded it. It's already set in stone. I recorded my stuff. So it's Dub T called Dope Check. D-O-P-E, Dope Check, Dope featuring Check. 2 Chainz. So that'll be coming out in the next, I'd say within the next 3 to 6 months. We have a European market. There's an artist over in Europe that's a number one artist. She's going to piggyback on the song to get it with the remix.
From where?
From Europe.
Europe.
And they got about, yeah, they have that market over there. She's number one in that market.
So you're like this close to exploding, man, huh?
So close. Shout out to my boy Quest. He's actually the head of the label and head of the A&R for Sony for his label, for our label. And he's already got the plan worked out. He's already got it on paper. He's already got them committed $75,000 in of
Europe. Where do you record all your stuff?
Atlanta. Or I do record here if I need to. Paradox Studio.
Paradox.
Yeah, off of George Dieter. Okay. And shout out Smoke. And but I record in Atlanta mainly all the time now. So that song will be coming out soon. But like I said, we got the European market ready to rock. I'm talking, they said about 75,000 just in promo, European money, promo money just for that one song.
It's like 90,000.
So I'm expecting a lot of big things from this, especially from this song in the next 6 months when it gets out.
Definitely a local icon. Definitely somebody is going to put
it. Shout out 2 Chainz.
Take the 915 to, you know, on the map now. We wanna sign off and thank you, you know, for being here, Larissa.
Thank you so much.
Can I shout out my social sites real quick?
Absolutely. No,
okay. Dubt915.com. You can check out all my social sites. It's just Dubt915. So check out my apparel, Dubt915.com, and any and all social sites, YouTube, Facebook, Snapchat, Dubt915. I repeat, at Dubt915.
Absolutely. I've got to your website, man. I'm impressed. I'm impressed with
it. Is on a rebuild because we had a lot of stuff there that would be called Fugazi now because we can't tour. Yeah. We can't run around the country. We can't do it. So we had to cut a lot of the stuff on the website for future events because of COVID. So
I saw your YouTube channel has a lot to look at. So I want to invite everybody to join the Dubt915 website, the Dubt915 Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. Check us out, guys. You have a lot to see. Learn about our local artists and local icons. I want to thank Ms. Larissa.
Thank you so much. And
you.
It was an honor, Dubt.
Thank you. I appreciate y'all. This was
what
fire.
You love, my man. Pops. All right. Guys, we'd like to see you guys next Friday as well. So you guys have a wonderful weekend. Enjoy.
Thank you guys so much for joining us. And we will see you next weekend.
God bless. See you later.
This segment is brought to you by Solar Team. Join the empire of solar energy today.
Ladies and gentlemen, there you guys have it, Dub T. It was such a pleasure. Like I said, now he lives in Atlanta, so make sure to support local. Go follow him on Instagram and keep up with all the great and amazing projects that he has going on because he's definitely representing El Paso in such an amazing way. So we send you all of our love, Dub T. Hope you're watching. And just to let you guys know, that segment, Local Icon, is now going to be icons, just icons, because we're bringing people from all over the world. How exciting is that, right? For next Friday, we actually have somebody from Miami. He is an amazing bodybuilder, and I know that most of you have heard, but if you guys want to see that interview, join us next Friday for our new and improved local icon that is now going to be Icon. All right, you guys, but for now, we're going to go ahead and take a little pause, and we're going to thank our special sponsors for this segment.
Business owners know that location is key. Look no further. Loop 10 Business Park is ready with top-notch retail space. Set in the corner of Rojas and Joe Battle, the busiest highway intersection in El Paso. This area funnels thousands of vehicles every hour to all quadrants of the city. your business endeavors should be noticed. And all characteristics of a successful business plan start here. Become an owner and never rent again. We have accessible pricing and the deal of the century. This is the American dream. Call now for more information.
It's 2021 and it's time for your new journey. Get certified in phlebotomy, EKG tech, or nurse's assistant. You can make it happen in just 4 to 6 weeks. Freedom Academy, heroes in the forefront. Call now and enroll today.
I don't know about you. There's something in his eyes, he's keeping secrets.
What a way to drop a bombshell, baby. Guess you really didn't think I'd find out. In the silence, cry. I'm on the side where the lights out. Know that you feel it, Know that you feel it,
so much to our sponsors. All right, so for Glam It Up, tonight we have Cesley, who is the owner of CDH Shop. And honestly, as a designer and an old boutique owner, I love her clothing. She has an Instagram, CDH Shop, so go ahead and follow, and let's see what she has for us tonight.
The catwalk, the photos, the lights, the camera, the action. Get on your prime and begin training today. Register at letstudio.com and become a halo model.
Hello everyone and welcome back to Glam It Up, brought to you by Live and Talented. I'm Andrea Chacon and today we have a new boutique in town and with me is Cesley. She opened up her own boutique called CDH. Thank you, Cesley, for joining us today.
We're so excited to have you here.
Yeah, I'm super excited to be here. So it's actually an online boutique, but yeah, it is here based in El Paso, Texas.
That is super awesome. And I mean, you started off in the whole pageant stuff and now you have your own boutique. Like, how did that happen?
So we go way back.
I know, we do go way back. So, but tell us, how did that happen?
I mean, I think I've always had a passion for fashion and it just directed in that way, and luckily this year I was able to pull it off and I'm super excited to be here. The boutique name is CDH and like I said, it's an online boutique and I'm super excited to show you guys some outfits today.
That is awesome and we're excited to see those outfits too. And you're totally right, you do have a passion for fashion. I mean, when we had our appearances in the whole like pageant world and all that stuff, you were always super fashionable.
Oh, thank you.
I was like, how does she do it? So now you have your own boutique, so I'm super excited to see what you have for us. So we're gonna bring out our first model, Mariel, so you can tell us about Mariel's look first.
Whoa. So this is a fuchsia pink mini dress. It's gonna be very fitted to the body and it does have those detailings in the front that make it a little bit more elevated. Definitely a little bit more sexy, risque, because it does go up a little bit on the leg, but it's super cool. We just paired it with some long boots, thigh highs, as we start, well, we're transitioning into cooler weather. But definitely as it gets cooler, you can wear a jacket on top, jean jacket, or even a blazer, and I love this dress. It's one of our new pieces.
It's beautiful and the color is just so vibrant. Pop. And it pops. Mm-hmm. Yes, and you're right. I mean, right now in El Paso we're supposed to be in fall, but we're still in kind of summer-like weather, but some days do feel like fall, so
yeah, at nighttime, I guess, right?
Yeah, right. And it looks absolutely gorgeous on Mariel, so yes. Thank you, Mariel. Definitely love it. I'm not gonna lie, I saw her earlier with the sunglasses on top of her head and I don't know why I thought she was wearing kitty ears. But up next we have our next model, Leilani, and I love this look. Tell me about this.
So this is definitely a more relaxed look. These are gonna be some basic jeans that are relaxed and they do go a little bit above the ankle. So you can definitely wear some kicks or, you know, some little heels, kitten heels. And then we just paired it with this beautiful oversized flowy royal blue top. I mean, this is more of a boho look. It's definitely, like I said, you can dress it up, dress it down, and I think it's super comfy and she looks great.
She does look great, and it definitely does look comfortable, and you can definitely dress it down a bit if you want to wear more comfortable shoes, or you can dress it up. Yeah. Like, it's super perfect. I absolutely love it, and it looks so comfortable.
Yeah,
and
let's again, trade. She has,
right?
Let's trade, Leilani. No, you look awesome. And then she has some sunnies on top, so those are featured on the website as well. But we just paired it with some sunglasses.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Leilani. You're definitely rocking that look. I really want to trade places right now. She looks so comfortable.
Yes, I love it.
But you have so many different looks for us, and now we're going to bring out Emily. So, Emily, we can come out here. Now, speaking about comfortable, this is another really comfortable look, if you ask me. So, tell us about Emily.
Absolutely. So, Emily is totally fierce in this outfit. These are some flowy, high-waisted, very fierce pants, and it's definitely a statement piece in your closet. And then we just paired it with a bodysuit that is snake print. The snake print is going to be a very statement piece for fall. And yeah, she looks awesome. This is definitely a night out, or you can definitely do brunch maybe as we start transitioning to cooler weather during the day.
Yeah, and I love the top. You know, you can switch it up and make it more casual, and you can just switch it up differently for different occasions.
Yeah, definitely just the pants alone with maybe a crop top since we're still a little bit hot. But yeah, I'm obsessed with these pants.
Yeah, from speaking with Emily earlier, she said that she loved them and she was super comfortable in them. So I'm definitely going to have to try those out. So thank you, Emily. You look gorgeous. And now we're going to bring out another one of our models, Dali. So if you can tell us about Dali's look.
So Dali's definitely a boho chic vibe. It's going to be just a little oversized dress that has the detailing in the front and the buttons going up to the neckline. We went ahead and paired it with a little hat to elevate the outfit, and I think she just looks so cool.
She definitely does. I absolutely love it, and I do need to start doing more of the hat type of situation. I'm not very used to it, but it looks so great.
It really does. It makes
definitely
it chic.
Yeah, and I feel like Dali definitely rocks this, and it's totally her style. I mean, I would hope because she definitely looks incredible and amazing. And I love that this is yet another look that you can either dress up or dress down depending on the occasion.
Even with some little booties just throwing on to make it more of a fall look. But we just went ahead and paired it with some heels as well.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Dali. And Dali looked absolutely gorgeous in that outfit. Super comfortable. I love the hat. That's something that I need to try more often, honestly, personally. But we do have another interesting look that you brought for us and that I really want you to tell us about. So we're going to bring out Natalia. Natalia, you can come out here. Tell us about Natalia's look.
So this is personally one of my favorites. It's definitely a bold boss babe statement piece. I think every girl should have a blazer in her wardrobe, as you would know.
Yes.
So we went ahead and went with the monochrome pieces with the hot pink, and then we went ahead and paired it with the same skin bodysuit. Again, it's transitioning into fall, a little bit more warm. But again, you can definitely just pair it with a tank top in the bottom. But I think this piece is definitely amazing.
It is super cute. I love it. And I'm not one for like bold colors and stuff, but this really makes a statement, and honestly, it makes me want to try it on.
Absolutely. And you can definitely, because the shorts and the blazer come together. You can definitely just do the blazer with some jeans, like I said, and then just pair it with like a crop top in the bottom. So make it a little bit more casual. But this one's definitely a bold boss babe statement.
Well, Natalia definitely looks like a boss babe. So thank you, Natalia. You're totally rocking this look. And now we're going to go a little bit away from those vibrant colors. And we're going to bring out Desiree so you can tell us about Desiree's look.
So this is definitely a black on black moment. These are jogger silk pants, and they're just super comfy. I mean, look at how amazing it looks on her body. She does have the accents on the feet, so those just elevate the pants themselves, and then also the tie on the waistline. And then we just went ahead and paired it with one of our new pieces, which is the bodysuit that has the slit in the middle, and it just elevates the entire bodysuit and also that one shoulder look.
I love the entire look, and I love the bodysuit with the whole one shoulder look. It's absolutely perfect. And because the other side is long sleeve, it's like you can still wear it right now.
Absolutely.
During the fall season, it's perfect. I absolutely love it. And of course, Desiree looks stunning in this.
Yes, she does.
And last but not least, thank you, Desiree. We're gonna go with, I think this is more of like a really fall look, if you ask me.
Absolutely.
And something that's really trendy with the whole like leopard type of pattern and stuff. So we're gonna bring out our last model, Jaylene, if you can come out here. So tell us about Jaylene's look.
So Jaylene is definitely that leopard look. These are gonna be some relaxed pants, flowy pants. And what's really neat about them is that they actually come with those overalls on top. So you can always pair it with a graphic tee or something fun. We just went ahead and went with our black basic tee that has the shoulder pad detailing on the top, which is really trendy this fall. And then we just paired it with some booties, or actually they're thigh highs, but I think it looks good. It looks elevated. Or you can always just wear some sandals or some kicks as well if you want to level down the outfit.
I love it. I think the shoulder pads on that blouse make it so unique, and it gives it that statement. Like, even though it's just a black shirt, like, yeah, it's not just a black shirt.
Yeah. It's not. Look again.
Yeah, look again. You were wrong.
Yeah, she looks great.
Yeah, she definitely does. So thank you, Jaylene. And we definitely appreciate you coming, and all of these looks were different, definitely a variety. They were all very different, so everyone at home got to see that you have a lot of different styles that people can find, and people can probably find a bunch more. So if people want to find you, where can they find you?
Absolutely. So the website is www.cdh/shop.com. Also, all the social medias are going to be here right below, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Looking forward, and remember to shop CDH.
Perfect. Well, you heard her. You got to shop CDH. I mean, you must have fallen in love with one of these looks.
At least one.
They were all amazing and different, like different styles. So I definitely love it and appreciate that you came here, and wish you the best of luck. I know you're going to continue to be growing. Let us know when you have, you know, your location for a boutique so we can bring you back and people can visit you once Miss Corona leaves us alone. But thank you so much for joining us. And for you guys at home, don't go anywhere because the show's not over.
Baila El Paso Baila. LAT Studio offers a full dance division with jazz, hip hop, ballet, and contemporary. Visit latstudio.com today.
Cesley, thank you so much for being part of Live and Talented. I love your collection, and I hope all you watching also enjoyed it. All right, you guys, so that's it for us tonight. Remember, next Friday we have a very special show for icons. All right, so give us a like on Live and Talented on Instagram, YouTube. We also have a mini reality series going on right now. So huge things, and we want you to be part of everything that we got going on. All right, so we'll see you next Friday.